Alright, hello guys. I have a very, very exciting video for you guys. Today we're going to be talking about our November snowfall forecast, basically. Who can expect to see snowfall in the month of November? We're going to be looking at our forecast for November as far as temperature, precipitation, and all that is concerned. Also, the average November snowfall in the regions that on average will see snowfall in November. Then we're going to bring you our exclusive November snowfall anomalies towards the middle portion of the video. And at the end, we'll be showing you guys model runs that have happened in the past day or two that have shown snowfall within the next 15 days and give you guys some example of what could be upcoming. Now, before I get started with this exciting video, please make sure to subscribe if you do like weather-related content, and also make sure to check out the links in the description for our social medias. Now, let's get right into things. Now, we're looking at that average snowfall for November. Ignore the medium shade of blue, light blue, and white colors. That's where we're expecting snowfall later than December and later than November. But in that blue, that deep, deep dark blue, almost a black color, that's where we're expecting to see snowfall before the month of December, aka November, October, September, and August. So August in a little bit of regions in the Rockies. These are the areas that on average you will see snowfall in the month of November, and it's going to be important to keep that in the back of your head as we watch this video, as I talk about who will see snowfall, an above normal amount of snowfall in November and a below average amount of snowfall in November. It's going to be important to see if you even expect to see snowfall this month. Now, let's get into our precipitation forecast for November. You can always check out the November video by clicking on my channel, and I uploaded it 2 days ago, so you can go find that if you want to watch the whole thing. Now, you can see we have a little bit of above average precipitation there for Montana and also east of Chicago and New Orleans. They're anywhere east of those two locations, basically. We expect above normal precipitation, and in that darker green, even more above normal. All those tan and brown areas, we're expecting below normal precipitation and most likely a little bit of below normal snowfall as well, obviously. Now, here's our temperature forecast, which is very, very exciting and very extreme. As you can see, we're expecting far below average temperatures for the north central United States. Going to be frigid. I talked about that in the November forecast. Again, go check that out if you want to hear the whole thing. But for the most part, a lot of the eastern United States, a lot of the northern United States are going to be very cold this month. And then we're going to have warmer temperatures for Florida and the southwest. So those areas, obviously Florida, we're not too worried about November snowfall. But for the southwest, we could expect some below average snowfall, especially in those areas that also had below average precipitation. But those areas that had a below average temperatures and above average precipitation or average precipitation, we're expecting a greater chance at above average snowfall, obviously. Here was my overall forecast as well, and I wanted to mention the northeastern portion here. I mentioned multiple snow chances, and a lot of people were like, well, what does that mean? And they were like, well, you don't expect snow chances this time of year. Well, you do, actually, so I don't know why people said that, because I just showed you your averages. But multiple snow chances means I'm not forecasting you're going to see snow. I'm saying there will be chances where we see snowfall chances throughout this. Some of those areas in that white shade will receive snowfall or see flakes at least during the month of November, obviously. So it's all just a chance thing, but I think there's going to be good chances for snow throughout the month of November for that region. Now, we're going to get into my exclusive snowfall anomaly forecast for November, which is very exciting. We're expecting a lot of above normal snowfall in a lot of areas in the northeast and north central United States. As you can see, for Montana, Great Lakes, New England, we're all expecting in that deeper blue to see above normal snowfall. In the lighter blue, it's not quite as much. We're not expecting quite as much above average snowfall chances or chance at above normal snowfall, but it is still there. And I think a lot of these regions, I'm not calling for above average precipitation, like the Dakotas and Minnesota, and that has a lot to do with it. But in the western United States, obviously, with the below normal precipitation and above normal temperatures, that combo should be quite obvious that we're expecting below average snowfall. Keep in mind, Los Angeles, obviously you don't expect snowfall there or a lot of those regions in that map, but you kind of have to pinpoint where they expect snowfall in there. That's why it's important for me to show you your average, obviously. Now, here's some storm tracks that I showed in a winter forecast a few months ago, and these are two that I expect to be very, very common chances in the month of November. So first is the Alberta Clipper, which we'll probably see a few of these. Keep in mind, this was a map that I made for the winter time, so it's going to be a little less snowy on those southern areas than this map is indicating, because this is intended for December, January, February, obviously, and we're only in November. So, you know, Kentucky, Tennessee, Virginia, Missouri. We're probably not expecting too good of a chance at snowfall compared to if this was January. So keep that in mind, especially those regions. Also, our second storm track here that I wanted to show is the Miller B Nor'easter, which kind of is a tandem with the Alberta Clipper because it starts as a clipper and then becomes more coastal. It just would have to have the right circumstances. And a lot of times they go together. And if you see a chance of Alberta Clippers, you see a chance of the Miller B Nor'easter as well. And you can see this one would bring heavier snow to coastal regions. Again, New York City, Boston, I don't know how good your chances at seeing snowfall this November. I don't think you're going to see a heavy snowfall event, you know, 12-inch plus snowstorm or anything. But if this was January, you would probably be looking at a good chance of that. Now, this is going to be a really exciting portion of the video as well, as we show some model runs that showed snowstorms very, very soon. And I want to show you guys that right now. Now, this was the Canadian model run today or last night. And you can see that for the 8th, you've probably heard about this. A week from now, some of the models are showing the chance at a good snowstorm for New England and some of the interior northeastern United States just a week from now, Friday into Saturday, November 8th through 9th. And the chance is there. I'm just not ready to make a whole video about it. Obviously, I'm not that confident in it yet. But as we get, you know, 5-4 days away, that's when I'm going to be ready to start making some snowfall forecasts for this one if they're still showing it. I'm going to watch it closely, so don't worry. But I have had a lot of people private messaging me about this one asking, hey, what's going to happen with the 8th snowstorm? So here it is. I just wanted to give it a quick cameo there and just show you guys that I do know that it's there and I am keeping a close eye on it, and there is a good chance I'll be making a video on it in the coming days. Now, here's the full evolution of this one. You can see it starts out in Montana and some of those northern Rockies on the 7th, and by the 8th, it's down there in the central United States, Missouri, Oklahoma, Kansas. It's pretty crazy. And then by the 8th, it is in New England and the northeastern United States, bringing moderate to heavy snowfall. This is actually a great example of the Miller B Nor'easter that I showed just a few minutes ago. This is a great on-screen example, so I'm glad I put this in there, actually. Now, we're going to take a look at the GFS as well, which has multiple snow chances over the next month. So it's going to be very exciting to show you guys a few of these that it's showing in the next 15 days. Now, the important thing to note with the snowfall chances is that you don't want to pay too much attention to the actual snowfall event that it's showing, at least when it's only, you know, a week, when it's a week plus out. But when it's within a week, sure, you can pay attention to the date because it's actually a pretty legitimate chance. But when it's 2 weeks out, we'll want to pay more attention to the actual pattern and ingredients that are there and say, okay, well, we will be in a favorable pattern for this to potentially something like this to happen within a few days of that actual date that is showing it. Here's the GFS during the same time the Canadian model shows that big snowstorm for the northeastern United States. And you can see not really there. There's some snow showers around, but hardly what the Canadian is showing. Here's by the 12th. It has a pretty decent interior New England snowstorm here. You can see upstate New York as well. Moderate snowfall throughout the mountain ranges and lake-enhanced snowfall. You can see a lot of lake effect snow going to be possible in the coming days, or coming weeks, that is. And it looking pretty warm for the lakes. So we, again, probably going to have a good chance at some lake effect snow. But this is actually a synoptic storm here. So we actually do have a pretty decent coastal storm here by the 12th on this model run. Again, don't pay too much attention to the exact date. Now, on November 18th, it also has a pretty decent nor'easter here. I had somebody comment like, oh, we're not going to be in a good pattern for nor'easters. Well, within the next 15 days on the models, I'm seeing, you know, chances for 3 or 4, probably only 1 or 2 of them will happen. But I mean, with a nor'easter, all it takes is 1 or 2 to bring your precipitation average above average for a whole month. So it just depends on the strength, but I am seeing chances for nor'easters. I don't know what that person was seeing, really, but this one is actually a pretty close call for a snowstorm as cold is moving in. So again, don't pay too much attention to the exact date, but if this one happens a day later and that snowstorm arrives a little bit later, this is a major snowstorm for New England. So definitely some chances at snowfall there. Now, here's another cool map. I just wanted to show you, this has a lot to do with the pattern that I mentioned, where we're looking for a favorable pattern. This one doesn't even have a snowstorm, but here's by the 13th, you could see just a giant trough in the eastern United States. This looks like December or January to me, and it's only November. Very, very exciting November, guys, coming up. I know I always talk about how exciting the weather is. This November, I'm extremely excited about because everything is lining up to be very active as far as snowfall. and cold in the United States, so it's going to be very fun to forecast a lot of things with you guys, and I hope you guys have subscribed and are ready to enjoy these weather events with me, because I'm just, you know, this time of year I always fall back in love with weather, if I've fallen out of love with it for some reason, but I fall more in love with weather every time around this year, as it gets so exciting for me to make videos on this type of stuff. But this pattern right here by the 13th looks very good for clippers and some lake effect snowfall, as that's going to be very cold over the Great Lakes on the 13th if that verifies. So we do see some great patterns for clippers and lake effect snow. Very, very exciting stuff. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. As always, be sure to share it with friends and family on social medias if you do think they'll find it useful or interesting. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.